that Mr. and Mrs. Kelly?
Yes.
Mr. Good, and I'm so.
Well, listen, it's good to have you in.
It's a pleasure.
And President Phil.
How are you, sir? I see.
Good to see you.
Could we get a group picture, Mr. President?
We sure can.
I get to see him again next Wednesday, so I'll stay on this.
Oh.
Right of me here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, I want to thank both of you because I understand that somebody here thinks that you had an awful lot to do with his getting elected.
Well, we never waited, we certainly did.
Well, I want to thank you because he has done everything he could to be supportive of what we're trying to do, and I'm glad you made it possible for him to be here.
That's right. Well, thank you, and we work for you too.
We're sure we're proud.
Thank you.
We're so proud just to get to meet you and how we're so overwhelmed.
He's a great president, and we're going to get him reelected.
Oh, boy, that's for sure. He is for sure. You'll be back.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Good to see you.
Thank you, sir.
For best of luck always to you. We're behind you 100%.
Thank you.
That alone.
Makes it very.
Let's get to it.
Thanks. Good luck to you.
God bless you.
Okay. RNC film crew is where?
What?
We do this in the middle of the.
What does it mean?
How are you, sir? Nice of you to be here to accept this. This is the artist, Dottie Kay, President Reagan.
Happy to.
And her sister?
Well, listen, thank you very much.
Her sister, Maxine?
Hello there. Nice to see you.
How are you, George Hanson? Nice to see you.
I was just looking, and I'm glad. I know that you usually are painting Indians there, and I'm glad that when you finally chose to do some pale faces, it turned out to be that.
I couldn't think of a better subject. You're like us, you're Western.
And that was a thoroughbred named Little Man who's now gone to the.
That's what I understand. Yeah.
I rode looks like you feel before it. Him, I rode his half sister, and before that, I rode their mother.
Is that
and
right?
That was 37 years of riding just that one family of horses. Took me through 37 years of riding.
Well, he was fun to paint. I enjoyed. I love horses anyway. I ride a lot.
Well, so do I.
Yes,
not
I
as
would.
Much as I used to.
Well, I don't either. Actually, I paint a lot now.
Well, I thank you very much. This is wonderful.
Oh, you're certainly welcome.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, you're looking great, as usual.
Well, I feel good. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oops. That's a good rub out there.
Oh, thank you.
For you, just as a little souvenir. Remember that.
You think I would ever forget this?
Mr. President, these ladies both ride, and this one was thrown and had four ribs go the other a while ago.
I'm not quite as fond of him as I was.
No, it can happen to anyone. He was a hunter, a jumper. And, and I've I had one crash that dislocated a shoulder and messed up a little bit. But you get back up.
And you go, yes, I've had to.
I like
you
the
are
sign.
As handsome
see,
as I
see the sign? It can be done, isn't it?
You've done it for me, too.
see the president sign on his desk? It can be done.
And that's true. Thank I just proved
thank
it.
You.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, how are you?
Lovely West Virginia girl.
Well,
yes, indeed.
Well,
Julie.
How are you?
Glad to see you.
I'll give you this first. This is on behalf of
the show. You might introduce yourself to those that are with us today.
This is Mrs.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Hello. I could have
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. Time to find out what all these are, but believe me.
See you.
I see you.
I see you.
Mr. President, this is an official invitation to be our grand marshal at our feature parade. I hope you will be able to make it. You're a little bit busy, I'm sure.
It's also like, I found out in the world as it is today, there are a number of people in the security detail that don't look with favor on. I think I might be a hazard to some of the others.
Mr. President, the leader of the minority would want to be with us, but Senator Byrd could not come, otherwise he would have been here. And the member of the House from the district in which the festival is held each year, Mr. Staggers. But we are appreciative of your gracious.
Well, I understand that I just got under the wire. Now you're completing your years as Cranberry Princess.
She's a student at West Virginia University.
Please.
Yes.
Where?
West Virginia University.
Tell them what you're studying, dear.
Elementary education.
Oh. That's wonderful. There aren't enough teachers these days who really have a calling. You can feel calling to do it. But I think that's wonderful.
You're very kind. We're very grateful. I assure you for all of those who are here.
I thank all.
And for West Virginia generally, we have more festivals in West Virginia than any state. Some 60 festivals. One is called the Sorghum Molasses Festival. And that was organized by little children, the size of these children in the grades. All over the state, we have them of one type or another. The Watermelon Festival included. Thank you so much.
I was thanking the one back in Eureka College in Illinois.
Yes.
They declared themselves little town near the pumpkin capital of the world. And every year had a pumpkin festival.
Yes. Well, I've been at one 23 consecutive years. That's at Independence in Preston County. Uh-huh. And that's the pumpkin festival. So we're especially happy though that on a busy day, and they understand that you would receive them. They shall go home and remember this, sir.
Well, I hope it's some pleasure, because I'm going to remember it with pleasure.
Thank you very much. It was very nice to meet you.
Well, nice to meet you. And good luck.
Thank you.
And thank you for my gifts.
Well, ooh.
Okay, don't lose those.
President Senator Hooker, yes.
Hi. How good to see you. It's awesome to see you. I have some distinguished gentlemen from the American Legion here today.
Judge Dan Crowley from Minnesota.
Yes.
Remember well, sir. Thank you.
Ron Dunn from Montreal, Canada.
Nice to meet you, Mr. President.
Don Jagers of Pass National.
Yes, sir. President.
Good to be with you again, sir.
Frank Hamilton of Indiana.
Mr. President.
Mr. President, we're a group of Legionnaires who belong to sort of a little subgroup. We have a group in Canada that started after World War II, and every president has been a member or is going to be. And we were pleased when we heard that you would accept honorary membership. Well, we're all Legionnaires, and we do nothing of an international political nature. We're simply goodwill to foster better relations between veterans in Canada and the United States. All of our members here are Legionnaires.
I'm a Legionnaire myself.
So,
no.
We'll just give you the paraphernalia of office, Commander, with us a badge. I want to just say a quick word for the President.
Mr. President, I want to thank you for the honor you've done to our association by accepting this honorary life membership in the Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans in Canada on the recommendation of our friends from the American Legion, with whom we have a strong fraternal ties.
Well, I'm the one who's honored. I'm most honored to be a member. participate in something that I think is so emblematic of the relationship between our two countries. We fought and bled together on more than one occasion.
I might say yours is a hard act to follow, sir, and when you addressed the American Legion Convention in Seattle, I was the one that had to speak afterwards.
It was a tough assignment. The crowd was filtering out and hung in there. We appreciate Senator Lugar coming with us.
Grateful to you for seeing this. The American Legion means a lot to us in Indiana.
Indiana, we're home base in Indiana.
Throughout this nation.
Frank Casa
brought us over here.
Veteran of four wars. Active duty.
The only person who is on active duty in four wars.
War one, war two.
Supposed to be the last one living, or two.
He was aide to General Hershey in the Selective Service System.
You know, is it? Meaning to get this into my age to try to bring it younger or anything, but I remember I was a boy when World War I was fought, and I've always wondered about something. I remember my mother taking us down to the railroad station when a troop train came through on its way. This was in Galesburg, Illinois, on its way east for overseas. And I remember all the soldiers out the windows and shaking hands and all, and I handed them a penny for luck. And I'd give anything in the world if I knew
where that penny was.
That's a nice thought. Who he was.
Thank you again, Mr. President.
Mr. President, we appreciate it.
Congratulations.
God bless you. Keep up the good work, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. My pleasure.
Good to be with you again. We'll be on board.
Thank you.
I was the commander when you were the chairman. Spoke at
Boston,
Massachusetts.
Well.
I remember the president, I don't remember you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. President.
Thank you.